So everyone, please go to the, your yesterday we were explore some of the data. Module one, right?
Yes.
Did anybody explore the word symbology?
No.
I don't think. Okay, let's play with some of the things. You know the basic feature, zoom out, zoom in, and everything on top.
Yeah.
But let's go a little more and deeper on an arc map, okay? So first thing.
How much module are we in right now?
First. Okay. So first thing we'll do, right click on the one of the layer. So what I did, I click on the layer country outline. Once you right click on the layer, there are used several sub-menu items. Copy, remove, everything. Copy means basically copy the same layer to another layer. That's a basic feature, we know that. Remove, of course, you delete. But click on the open attribute table. So right click on the country outline or any other layer, that's fine.
Country outline.
Right, and right click open attribute table. Once you click that, use the table. Right? But you notice that in ArcMap, the information on the image also has contains the data.
Yeah.
So we need to understand, if we change the data, we can also change the data, also we can change the map or line or segment. Okay? So let's see the what data we have in the country attribute table. Informations. In ArcMap, the store as object ID, this object ID, this object is that, the information. Second thing that, what shape it is, a polygon, line or point. So we'll go through that also. So in ArcGIS, only three ways you can store the data, either line or polygon or a point. Give me an example, what line could be representing.
Borders,
distance? Roads? You said, okay, distance. But roads can be line. Road can be polygon, right? Borders?
Borders?
No, borders, no. Like borders means the country border could be polygon.
Oh, okay.
Columns?
Yeah. What
columns? For a line.
Continent?
No. Continent will be also polygon, it's a boundary, it's an area.
River?
River. River. Road. What else? A route. Your travel route could be line. Current polygon, current point. Right? What else?
Mountains. Mountains.
Mountains cannot be line. Mountains is, could be a polygon. You can shape.
City.
Shape, yes. City cannot be line. City is a 1 point feature.
Railroads.
Railroads can be current polygon, can come in the same place.
Highways.
Highways, roads. Roads, rivers, railroads. Your path, walking path, street path. Your car route, bicycle routes. Those are line features. What are the polygon features? Polygon, internet? Yeah, continent? Continents, countries, cities, counties, lakes. What else? You yesterday explored a lot of the models. Can you just remember?
Forests,
land areas. Country outline, lakes, at least you can see 3 years.
Clouds.
Clouds. Yeah, clouds. Of course, you can map the cloud in the game, into the clouds. So those are the polygon features. Right? And third is the dot dot or point. So point, if you draw in the map on the global scale, cities are point. Right? But if you drive a map of New York City, only New York City, that can be a point. It could be area, polygon. Make sense? And within a polygon, you have small polygons of house areas, the parcels. And one big polygon of city can contain the lines again. So depend upon which resolution you're drawing a map, you can decide if you're point or polygon. Make sense? If I'm drawing the, for example, this. So here your cities are the points. You see this? But when you draw New York City, you can have polygon. Okay? So three features always. Line, polygon, and our point. So we are working on those three features. Now I just click on country outline, and what you see here is the state is a polygon. But same time, if I click on the last city, shape our point. Okay? And similarly, if I click on the river, shape will be polyline. Online. Okay, so now let's go back to the country outline attribute table. So let me pick a country. So what happened when in the here if I select particular country like Ecuador, you can see the Ecuador change color. So you can identify where each of the values in the map you just select. So if I pick Ecuador and then I select one more country maybe here. Paraguay, Peru. You can select it. So that way you know which value in tables looking on the map. Because they are linked to each other.
Where do you find the table?
Sorry. Okay, right click on the layer. Open attribute. So this way you can see the information. Okay. Now let's go to a few more layers and see what information we have here. If I keep river attribute table. All lines you see here on the blue lines on your computer are having name. The names are here. River name. Okay? Now again you can do same thing. Select particular rivers here. You see the lines where the location. And each of the line or each of the river, they have information how many long the line or river is. In the length, in miles and kilometers. And also in addition to the river name, they also have which system belongs to. So where they merge to. So Amazon River Basin has multiple rivers together. Because all river converts to Amazon River. Okay, so the systems. Okay, sir. Can you similarly play with the cities? So they have few cities listed here, which has one of the largest populated cities in across the globe. So what we learned today in next half an hour, now you have some data. Suppose assignment one, I give a data of particular CO2 emission globally, countrywide. How can I bring the data from Excel spreadsheet to here, create a new map? So maybe you have data on your own research. Okay, you went to different countries, you met 10 people in each country, or 40 number of people, and you want to map that, you can do that. But when you have data, means you have data not only mine, but you want to have data in the subtext format or Excel format. So I give a data, sample data of CO2 emissions each country wide. And we want to bring the data from the Excel spreadsheet and create a map here, an R map. Okay? So that we will learn as a first experiment. But before going to that, let's go one more thing here. Right click on the country outline, look at properties. So properties box you will use several times during the next few days or whenever you use ArcMap. Right click on the country outline, click on properties. And click on symbology. And can you just see that you can color, you can change the color? First, let's test them if you can change the colors of the your map. And then I'll explain how to change the color.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's hard to see.
I think it is good. It is the reservation with the laptop. There is not. But I'll check with the IT guy if they can make it more legal. You can choose different color to represent your data. Okay. Now, if you look at this map, you look like, oh, well, Africa is all blue color. It doesn't differentiate the countries in Africa. Right? Can we play with this more? Right? And if all have same data, I'm going to represent, doesn't look good. So let me play with this data. I'll go back to right click again. Properties. There's a 5 classification. I can maybe make it maybe 9 class classification. Okay, at this I can see some changes here in the African country. Okay. Let me play some more here. Now again go back to the same, go to properties and classify. Let's click on classify and I'll see, okay, can I make equal interval? That's not good. So I can distinguish one country or other country with the values.
So
classify.
So okay, you're right. No, the color is not changing. Because if you look at this arrangement, the country data is below and flag area up. So flag area up here.
So change. You have to play with this quantized class B system. And you layer it off. Yeah, now this layer is off. Alright. So we learn how to create a symbology, how to classify the data, whether requirement what you did you notice something when you check equal interval or natural breaks? Anything, the values here?
Yeah.
So basically, when you choose the interval, you can decide your interval your own. You can do manually also. Okay. So I will give a couple more minutes to play with this again, and then we'll go for next one. Yes. So, yes.
But she's still in the
Okay, so to get old project, you have to add the data first. So let me add the data. You did not click add data. So click the this icon add data. And you go to your folder, downloads folder. Select assignment number one. Double click on it. Double click on folder country shape file and select shape file and add. So we are able to add container shape file. Now let's add the Excel file also here. Click add data. Go back to one level up and select the pseudo engineer word.xls file. And select data and add. Data is one of those sheet in the Excel file. Now, there is no connection there because there are two separate files. Our objective to connect those data together. To connect two people together, you have your same sync, right? You need to connect each other, you need to have some sync, whether your same class or your same city or something has to be sync, or same your brother, same. So we need to find what sync is there between us.
Sync.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
So can you find out? Can you how to find out? Country name is sync, right? Okay, can you do a country name? A sync parameter? But what happened? There are a lot of countries that have different names. Some want to write Spanish or some can change the name. Some can change the name from Republic of Korea to Korean Republic. Or some Ivory Coast to the Potato Ivory. Like that of can change the name. Is that make sensible decision?
Yeah.
It won't match. Right? So first thing we'll do, go back to the right click on your file.
Yes, sir.
And find what attribute tables you have in.
Which file? The data or the
data? Yeah, both the files. Open one by one. So this is a one file. And okay. and also right click on data and on open. So you see in the bottom countries and data together. Open side by side.
Open both of them.
Yeah. And see which parameter could be good.
Joining code here.
So where are data not available?
not drawing, so this is not.
How many colors are added? Is like four then?
One, two, three, four.
Oh, I see.
So we have four colors here. Got it? Anybody who not able to join the data? Can you open up your map? Okay, perfect. Do it. Yeah. You are able to join?
We're showing now.
Data view layout here. So I'll click layout.
Oh, it's at the bottom. Right.
Or you can go to the view and layout view also. Now, if you want to go to the insert, everything appears here. Okay? So, what we'll do basically insert title.
What if the layout is zoomed in to one section of the map?
Yeah.
Zoom out the picture. Zoom out the picture.
Zoom out the original
from the original. Yeah.
For your question, you also have this layout menu bar to zoom out, zoom in.
Oh,
so
you can zoom out from the layer.
Okay.
What's
so,
the
so you're creating a first map. I mentioned that the metric ton per capita per year. Metric ton. So, okay. But now, if you give your arrange this map nicely, you can understand this picture with of this little page. Your map is very small, 30% covering. A good map skill we need to use now. What are you going to do?
Landscape.
Can you guys do landscape now? Can you figure out how to make a landscape map? This is a portrait, right? Make a landscape pitch setup. Let me see how many of you can able to do landscape yourself. Do landscape pitch setup. Just go to the file.
where did you go?
that's all that's important to.
So now your maps look like not properly setting up. So you use to pull this water there. You rearrange your content and then you see in the screen. Right?
And your name.
Awesome.
And your scale.
Oh, wait, how did you get
there? Scale.
Okay.
Wait.
They're
just
one faces. One.
What's your name, young man?
One. One. Two. Fix it.
So I measure here, go back to again, those people are not able to make it to full decimals. Right click here, country file, properties, and right click here, and in format level. And here is decimal to decimal. Okay? Now, there's one more thing here. Everyone, please listen here. Very important. If you see these numbers, those numbers are even though randomly picked based on the equal natural break, but you can change those numbers also. You rearrange your map. From the 0.1 to 1.17. It is 1.17, can I make it 1.2? Or is it 5.89, can I make it 6?
So you just double click on the number and
no.
The properties of the label?
Under the properties.
Yeah.
Under the code of the properties, countries, properties, and range. List of 5.89 and 6 here. Everybody able to change this map? Once you put your name, please go back to print. We are printing it, we play a PDF file. So I will do a couple of more minutes and then we'll go to our next experiment. Our next assignment. Okay? Alright, let's go. One last thing before we go to the next experiment, please look at the screen. Now, here if you see the legend, the word legend not necessary to be there. The word legend not necessary there. What is legend? So this whole bar is legend, right? You don't tell a title. You cannot put title COD emission. You just put COD emission there, right? You just add title, column, COD emission now. So similar region, we don't do word region there. Right click, properties, general, and delete this region. Okay, so your region word is gone. Okay? Now next thing, this emission is for 2010, year 2010, right? What countries is doing there? You know what countries should be there? Response, C later there. Yeah. Doesn't look good, right?
What if you want to capitalize this?
Yeah, we can capitalize it, okay? But this country doesn't make sense. So what I'll do here, slowly right click here on the country and change the name. CO2 emission.
Please save your, export your map.
So whatever you have checked,
an active bush. Yeah, they're pushing up on your leg, and you have to manually take that. He changed it to the same as that manager title.
This is the first step, right? So please give it to my first app, your name, that will remember that she is first your GIS app. So PDF? Why? Why word is written there? Why are words written?
Oh, why did you cut it?
Why word legend is there? Why the word legend is here? This is a legend automatic, right? So that click properties, no, we will not go like. Sure. Yeah, yeah. That click. In general. Delete this.
Alright, you okay?
Perfect. What is DIN? Oh, DIN.
First name, middle name, and initials.
Yes?
Your scale, it doesn't matter if I have it.
Yes.
Okay.
This is a lovely program. All right. So I'm sure all of you are able to export the map to JPEG format, which looks similar to this. I understand you can have any numbers of scales, any numbers of classification. There are different terms, that's fine to me. But you should be, when you get a map, you should fit properly. Should a smaller map and bigger regions. Now, there's proportion. Okay? So whenever you develop in future a map, make sure your map is bigger. Your legend should be a little smaller, maybe a 10% of the map size, approximately. The standards. Your title should be bigger than your name. Your name should be smaller. Okay? So these are the common traits. Some people put name is minor, bigger name and title smaller. So have some proportional format the size of the text in your map. Okay? And make sure that your color should be proper also. If somebody picked the higher CO2 emission, green color, and low emission is a red color, doesn't make sense, right? So make sure that when you create any map, you should understand what is color means, what color significance of, all right? So when you export, go back to the assignment number 2, download assignment number 2. In assignment 2, instead of global map, I gave you America map, USA maps, and data for USA. Okay, so do same process and do yourself. If you need help, I will help you. Okay?
What's the first thing?
close this one.
Excel file doesn't understand ArcMap.
Do you know if you can help with anything?
always a CSV file. Alright, so when you say a CSV file, change the name of the file. Please change the name of the file. Literally, we add one or two in front of it.
What? Photo and you can still?
No. Name of the file.
Oh, the file, okay.
So you don't have mistake the game adds the Excel file there. Alright.
Is this module 2?
Yeah, module 2. And then once you add a CSV file, the same step what I explained to you before, joining the. Okay?
Yeah.
So if you're going to have a map like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a Texas. Florida is missing, Texas is missing, right?
These are the states.
Why are you missing? Okay, now, huh?
Are they
known? No, 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 no. So there are, if you open your Excel, a spreadsheet I given to you, there's a data, Texas is there.
All three, yeah.
All three are there. But when you join, it's not joined. Why?
There's
some matching. But even if you check, okay, here is also code is TX, there's also code PX. Why not matching? The first thing is your data, right? Data is there in Excel spreadsheet. Your Texas state already in the your shape file. You join in, it joined, you went back, you check, oh, here is the TX is there, this Texas code is there, right? Still not joining. What is the problem?
Is it the STUSPS, like the, when you're joining the state, it's not the same?
Same.
It is the same?
Yeah, go back and check. TX and TX, both the places.
Are they different file names?
No.
What? I just not know.
If you cannot figure, you cannot create a map. What is the problem? Your text is matching, right? Take code is matching. It still is an issue.
S V U S P S.
No.
How do you know it's not joining?
No, you're joining properly. Everything is perfectly doing here. The issue there is the issue there is. Huh?
Is it the order like of the states?
No. The issue there is in your Excel file. Click on the TX, the tab, the box. There's a space after X. There's space after TX. Open your Excel file.
Okay.
There's a space on, if you look at this file, you open Excel file. Right? And go to TX, okay? Fix up. Okay, look, just go to the TN, right? If you click up to here, look at front, look at the screen, please. Everybody look at the screen, please.
Yeah.
Look at the screen, okay? If you put a space, there's only two letters, T and N. In Texas, if you look, there's three letters. One is T, X, and third is space. Even the space, when you join a table, matters. The space, after TX. Matter. Wow. So what you do basically? Go back to the Excel, delete the spaces after X, and again join back.
How do you debug and troubleshoot that?
That's the problem.
So something like that.
That skill you develop. So I'm adding that skill in your mind by teaching this. Okay. So rejoin them. Remove the join. Go back to Excel and remove the space and join back. Okay. Understand? So these are common problem you might face in future. I don't want to that time bother. Right now you're learning, right?
But you have to look at the dimensions of the cell.
Yeah.
So that's how you can troubleshoot it.
Yeah, that's advanced level. But at this moment you know that the difference.
So now we have to start.
Okay, you got it?
Wait, there are other states that have space.
Really?
Yeah.
So whatever you do, you show up.
Can you show me your passport?
Alright. Okay, now before I go to help you to remove the join, simple step. So already you joined there, go to ArcMap, right click your data, and join and remove join. Remove all joins.
You're missing one.
And remove your file, Excel file from here as well. Remove the join, remove Excel file, modify Excel file, remove the carry errors, space, and then join back. Okay?
Alright.
You got it?
Indiana?
Yeah. Florida,
Kansas.
It always says that. It always says this problem. It always says that.
Not even that.
The last one.
Do your work, right? Yeah. Are you challenged?
It is not that I.
So let me fix the answer to the excellence by the hope of the problem. So easy way to go, when you want to remove space on Excel and Excel on the thing. If you want to remove space on Excel, you don't have to go one by one. Go, you know, find replace. And find what? Space.
Thank you. Okay.
can get an email.
So because the session is being taken care of today at 12, right? That's what they said in the email?
Yes.
All right, we're going to give you guys...